Hi, in this tutorial, we're going to learn how to create this marquise effect in Figma, or the infinite scroll effect in Figma. My name is Jacqueline and this is Acquia Designs. Let's get started. So first, we're going to create our text. To do that, either press T on the keyboard or select the text tool from the tools menu. Next, we're going to customize the properties of the text. So we'll change the text font and then the size. Following that, we're going to draw the star shape. So we'll select the star tool from the shapes menu and then draw it in our canvas. Then change the values of the various properties as seen on the screen. Next, we're going to duplicate the shape and move it to the next space between the two texts. Select everything there and make sure they're center aligned. Next, we're going to create this ellipse shape. To do that, either press O on the keyboard or select the ellipse tool from the tools menu and then edit the properties to match what you see on the screen. Moving on, create a duplicate of the first ellipse, create a fill for it, remove the stroke, and then move it to the front. With the duplicate still selected, select the second ellipse and select subtract from the boolean menu up there. Duplicate the first ellipse once again. Create a fill, remove the stroke and move it to the front. With the duplicate still selected, select the third ellipse and select subtract. Then select all three and select union. Select the text and the stars, duplicate it and move it to the right. Duplicate the star shape and move that between the text. Duplicate the ellipse shape and move that to the other end of the text. Now select everything, group it and create a duplicate. Move the duplicate to the far right and adjust the spacing between the two groups. With the two groups selected, frame the selection. Move the end of your frame to the left while holding Command or Control on your keyboard and tick the clip content box. Duplicate the frame, select the test group in the second frame and move it to the left. Now select both frames and create a component set. Switch to the prototype tab and link the frames using the connections on the screen. Select after delay and set the duration to 1. Then select Smart Animate and select Linear and set the duration to 10,000 milliseconds. Connect the second to the first one, select after delay, set the delay to 1. Make sure Smart Animate is selected and set the duration to 1 as well. Now create a duplicate of the component, move the first group towards the left and then move the second text group towards the right. Create a bar on the frame by selecting R on the keyboard or selecting the rectangular tool from the shapes menu. Next, change the color to green. Add a stroke and set the width to 2. Grab the components from the components menu in the menu bar. Press K on the keyboard and adjust it to match the width of the frame. Select the frame and the rectangular bar and press Command G to group them. Rotate the group a little bit and drag it down. Then frame the selection by pressing Command Option G on the keyboard. Duplicate the frame and rotate it to the other side. Change the fill color to black and change the stroke color to green. Using the Unsplash plugin in Figma, we'll download an image of a smiling woman. Then remove the background using the Icons 8 Background Remover plugin. Adjust the size of the image using the Scale tool. To do that, press K on the keyboard. Next, create a rectangular shape and move it to the front of the image. Then set it to linear and adjust the colors. Create another rectangular shape on top of the layout and round the corners. Using the text tool, type let's go and adjust the properties by changing the font and changing the size. Create a stroke, remove the fill, and set the stroke width to 3. And there you have it, the infinite scroll or marquise effect in Figma.